الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، my dear respected brothers in Islam, in the last khutbah I have discussed the fadilat of having children, and Anbiya alayhim salatu wasalam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for children, and it is a great ni'mah, blessing, barakah, and rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I was mentioning some of the adab and etiquette when you are blessed with a newborn. So the first thing I mentioned, that you should call adhan and iqama in the ear of the children. And also, you're supposed to do the tahniq. And you should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessing. And I mentioned that wives and daughters are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is us who divided and distinguish between the both, that girls are rahmah and boys are ni'mah. But from the Quran and the Sunnah we learn, both are barakah and rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my respected brother and sister Islam, when the child is 7 days old, the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to do the aqiqah and to give the child a beautiful name and to shave the hair of the child. The hadith is found in Tirmidhi by Samura radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, kullu ghulamin raheenun bi'aqiqati, that every child is pledged by his aqiqah. تُزْبَحُ عَنْهُ يَوْمُ سَابِعِهِ. We should be, the aqiqah should be alayhi wa sallam. The aqiqah should be done on the 7th day. On the 7th day. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, on the same day, meaning on the 7th day, يُحْلَقُ رَأْسُهُ. His hair should be shaved and he should be given a beautiful name. From other ahadith we learn that we can give a child beautiful name on the 1st day or the 3rd day or the 7th day. It is up to you. And also the sunnah is to slaughter one goat for daughter or for girl, and 2 goats for wife, for sons. But if you want to slaughter 2 goats for girls is fine as well. Alhamdulillah, I did sacrifice 2 goats for my daughter because I have a big circle of friends and family. And if you want to slaughter 1 goat for boy, for son, it is fine as well. In fact, it comes in the hadith of Tirmidhi by Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says, أبقى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الحسن شاتا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم slaughtered 1 goat for his grandchild حسن رضي الله تعالى عنه. 1 goat, not 2. And also he said, وقال يا فاطمة احلقي رأسه وتصدقي بزينة شعره فضة. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, the mother of Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, to shave the hair of Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and then she should wait the hair and then she should donate the silver to the weight of the hair, which is like if you want to do, it's kind of difficult sometimes to wait the hair of the boy or the daughter. So for safe side, you can donate like $15, $20 inshallah. So you don't have to literally donate silver or gold. You can give some donation in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the actual sunnah is to slaughter a goat or sheep on the seventh day. But if somehow or some way it's difficult to do the aqiqah on the seventh day, then you can do on the 14th day or the 21st day or the day that comes on the count of seven. The hadith is found in Nail al-Awtar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-aqiqatu tuzbahu bi-sab'in wa li-arba'ashara wa li-ihda-wa-ishreen. The aqiqah should be done on the 7th day or the 14th day or the 21st day. And also, my dear respected brothers and sisters, Islam, when it comes the name, make sure you give your children beautiful, beautiful name. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith of Abu Dawood, reported by Abu Ad-Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, تدعون يوم القيامة بأسمائكم وأسماء آبائكم, that you will be called on the day of Qiyamah by your name and the names of your father, like Muhammad, Imam Ahmad, Brother Shah, and you will be called by your name and also by the name of your father, not mother. You know, it is a concept in Desi culture that on the Qiyamah you will be called by your mother's name. No, you will be called on the day of Qiyamah by your name and your father's name, like Ibn Shamsul Arafin, Ibn Tahibai, and so on and so forth. So you will be called by your names and your father's name. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَأَحْسِنُوا أَسْمَاءَكُمْ. So when it is time to select the name of your children, make sure you don't go unique names, but make sure you take a beautiful name. حَسَنْ أَحْسِنُوا, take a beautiful name for your children. Bilal, Abdullah, Abdurrahman, Hamad, Qasim, you know, Abu Bakr, Umar, Osman. You see, these are the beautiful names. Nowadays, it is a trend to look and search the unique name. You know, this is not according to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But in one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تسموا بأسماء الملائكة وسموا بأسماء الأنبياء. Do not take the name of Malaika, like Jibreel, Mikael. They are beautiful names, but do not give this name to your children. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take the name of Anbiya alayhi wa sallatu wa sallam. Yusuf, Yaqub, Zakaria, Adam, Nuh, Lut, you know, these are the beautiful names of Anbiya alayhi wa sallatu wa sallam. Saleh, you know, and Dawood, Sulaiman, Muhammad, Ahmad, you know. And in one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ أَحَبَّ أَسْمَائِكُمْ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ وَعَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ. The most beautiful names to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are Abdullah and Abdul Rahman. So you know, Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala used to not look for the unique names. There are 300 Sahaba named Abdullah. And there are a lot of Sahaba like Abu Huraira, the famous Sahabi. We call him Abu Huraira, but his actual name is Abdul Rahman. You know? And especially when we live in America and Europe, we make sure to give our children the beautiful name, not a unique name. So this name is your identity. So if your child wants to hide his identity, his Islam, her Islam, he or she should not be able to do so. إن أحب أسمائكم إلى الله عبد الله وعبد الرحمن. You know? And if you look at the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, when the children used to be brought in his company, he used to give some certain names, Abdullah, Abdurrahman, Ibrahim, Musa, these kind of names the Prophet ﷺ used to select for the newborn children. And also, it is sunnah to do the khatna on the seventh day or whenever is away, whenever it's time. And according to the Bukhari, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam performed his khatna when he was 70 years old. The Prophet alayhi wasalam did the khatna of Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu when he was 7 days old. And my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, when the child begins to talk, the first thing you should teach him is the name of Allah, like you teach your children, Baba, Mama, right? Dada, Nana. You should teach him the word Allah and then La ilaha illallah. It comes in the hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, إِذَا أَفْصَحَ أَوْلَادُكُمْ فَعَلِّمُوهُمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. When your child begins to talk, the first thing you should teach him is La ilaha illallah. So La ilaha illallah is like you are giving him Islam. You are introducing him Islam. And the Prophet ﷺ says, ثُمَّ لَا تُبَالُوا مَتَامَاتُ. After converting him to Islam, you should not worry about him, his future, his career. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take care of. And my dear respected brothers and sisters, Islam, when the child is young, like 4 years old, 5 years old, teach him Islamic manners, Islamic akhlaq, because this is the time when you teach him or her something, it is a line in his thought. العلم في الصغر كالنقش في الحجر. This is the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. علم, learning something, knowledge in childhood is like a line you put on his stone. In my respect to brothers and sisters Islam, nowadays I hear the word hyper. My child becomes hyper. He is so much sharati, he does so much shaitani. But if you look at the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, the Prophet ﷺ liked those children. He loved the children who are sharati. He said in the hadith reported in Nawadil Usul. Nawadil Usul is a book written by Hakim al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah. The Prophet ﷺ said, أَرَامَةُ الصَّبِيِّ فِي صِغْرِهِ زِيَادَةٌ فِي عَقْلِهِ. The sharpness, I'm not going to say hyperness, sharpness of child in his childhood is a sign of his smartness, his intelligence. And I observe in my family, the children, I have 4 children, alhamdulillah, I have some experience. So those children who were sharp and hyper, they have good manner when they are mature. In the other hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, عَرَامَةُ الصَّبِيِّ نَجَابَ. Sharpness of child is the sign of his good manner. So the child who does most batamizi or shaitani, I saw in my life, alhamdulillah, when they are mature, they have good manner and they are smart, they are sharp. And my dear respected brothers and sisters, Islam, make sure you do not put so much burden on your children when they are 4 years old, 5 years old. Alhamdulillah, we used to live in Saudi Arabia. In Saudi Arabia, the elementary school starts when the child turns 6 years old. I saw here 4 years old. In Pakistan, 3 years old, people put their children in school. Look at the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. The hadith of Tirmidhi, reported by Abdullah bin Amr bin As radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال مروا أولادكم وهم أبناء سبع سنين. They command your child to perform salah when they are 7 years old. Meaning, salah is the most important part in Islam. Most important thing in Islam. And you do not command him, you do not ask him to perform salah until they are 7 years old. So before 7 years old, do not put him into trouble. Do not be so much tough and rough for salah, for fasting, for being this, for reciting the Quran. Be easy. The more you be easy with him, inshallah, the more he will have free time. Inshallah, when he turns 7, then little bit command him for salah. Because salah is Quran as well. Because in salah, you read the Quran. So before 7 years old, be easy going. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَضْرِبُوهُمْ عَلَيْهَا وَهُمْ أَبْنَاءُ عَشْرِ سِنِينَ. And when they are 10 years old, then be tough and make sure they are forming salah and they are reading salah. And when they have to perform salah, then you have to make sure they are learning Quran, they are memorizing Quran. In the hadith of Tirmidhi, reported by Abu Musa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَأَنْ يُؤَدِّبَ الرَّجُلُ وَلَدَهُ خير له من أن يتصدق بصاع. That educating your children with the best manner is better than that you donate in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning that good manners, good akhlaq, good adab is something very unique in Islam and you have to focus in it more than anything else. In the hadith of the Tirmidhi again, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا نَحِلَ وَالِدٌ وَلَدَهُ مِنْ نَحْلٍ أَفْضَلُ مِنْ أَدَبِ الْحَسَنِ. The best thing that you can teach your children, the best thing that you can provide your children, not iPad, not iPhone, not PS3 and Xbox. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best thing that you can give them, good akhlaq, good manners. In the last hadith, is found in Tirmidhi by Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَدِّبُوا أَوْلَادِكُمْ عَلَىٰ ثَلَاثِ خِصَالٍ. Make sure you teach your children three things. حُبُّ نَبِيِّكُمْ, the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَحُبُّ أَهْلِ بَيْتِهِ, and the love of the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, i.e. the love of Ahlul Bayt, who was Ali, who was Fatima, who was Hassan, who was Khadija, who was Aisha, who was Safiya, who was Zainab and Khadija, Zainab and Hafsa. Make sure you introduce the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to your children. And the last thing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the third thing, وَقِرَاءَةُ الْقُرْآنِ. Teach them how to read the Quran. How to read the Quran, make sure your children finish one time Nazar of Quran. فَإِنَّ حَمَلَكَ الْقُرْآنِ فِي ظِلِّ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ مَعَ أَنْبِيَائِهِ وَأَصْفِيَائِهِ. Because those who learn the Quran will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day in which there will be no shade except the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, as you all know, we are starting full-time HIFS program from this Monday, from June 5th. HIFS program, alhamdulillah. And inshallah, Imam Ahmad Siddiqui will be conducting classes from 9 to 2 o'clock. Inshallah, we started from summer, and the program will continue after summer as well. So if you have your children, if you want your children to memorize the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please do enroll, please do register your children. Inshallah, I'll be helping my brother as well, because two of my children also memorizing the Quran. Alhamdulillah, two of my children have already memorized the Quran. And alhamdulillah, I used to take them from New Kenya to Adil Masjid. It was 45 minutes driving to go and then come back and then afternoon, go back again, pick them up, and then 3 hours drive. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, now this program will be in your masjid and maybe 5-10 minutes driving. So make sure you take full advantage. We have only limited seat available. So the first come, first serve, make sure your children are memorizing the Quran. Inshallah, if you don't want to make them happy in this program, they can start like their memorization of Quran, their qaida. And inshallah, for more information, you can talk about Ahmad Siddiqui. And this program will be starting from this Monday, June 5th. Inshallah, al-Azim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to take full advantage of this program and all the Islamic programs. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi.